Our top focus at this hour, Indian External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar has arrived in Dushanbe for the Shanghai Cooperation Organization Foreign Ministers Meet. Jaishankar met with his Afghan counterpart, Mohammad Hanif Atmar, in Dushanbe and discussing the recent developments in Afghanistan. Now, India happens to be a major stakeholder in the peace and stability of the country, and it has been supporting a national peace and reconciliation process, which is Afghan-led, Afghan-owned and Afghan-controlled. The key agenda of the SEO meeting will be Afghanistan. The foreign ministers' meeting at the Tajik capital city is crucial. It comes at a time when the United States is pulling out troops from bordering Afghanistan and the Taliban at the same time is making rapid territorial gains in the country. The SEO contact group on Afghanistan is expected to evolve a strategy for the future of Afghanistan, and a joint statement will also be issued by the SEO contact group on Afghanistan. Now, India and Pakistan are also a part of this grouping, and the crucial meeting will witness the presence of the 8 member grouping nations, including Russia, China, Uzbekistan, Kazakhstan, Kyrgyzstan and Pakistan this year. This means that the Indian External Affairs Minister, S. Jaishankar, will be coming face to face with Pakistan's Shah Mahmood Qureshi. And remember, during the SEO National Security Chiefs meet last month, the Indian National Security Advisor, Ajit Doval, had targeted the Lashkar-e-Toiba and Jaish-e-Mohammed. He had proposed an action plan on the terrorist groups. Jaishankar will later represent India at the South Central Asia Connectivity Meet. Uzbekistan will be hosting the Connectivity Summit on July 14th and 15th, and India is expected to pitch for landlocked Central Asia's connectivity with the Indian Ocean region via Iran, the Chabahar port and international north-south transport corridor. Uzbekistan is eyeing to connect with India through the Chabahar port and is a part of a trilateral with Iran and India. It wants to push a smoother multimodal connectivity link between South Asia and Central Asia. Now, Beyond's principal diplomatic correspondent, Sidhan Sibal, is joining us live for more on the story. Sidhan, thanks so much for joining us. Now, India's foreign minister has begun a very crucial Central Asia tour, and he met his Afghan counterpart, of course. Tell us a little bit about the agenda and the discussions.
Well, today, of course, will be an important day in terms of number of bilaterals. He is likely to have a bilateral with his Chinese counterpart. The last such bilateral between the two sides was in the month of September last year on the sidelines of, again, SEO foreign ministers' meeting in Moscow. So this time around, the focus will be not only when it comes to Afghanistan connectivity, but other regional issues, bilateral issues. We know already he has met the Afghan foreign minister and discuss the Afghan peace process.
Right. Now, Sidhan, India is, of course, a big stakeholder in the peace situation in Afghanistan. So how will the ongoing developments impact Indian policy with the country?
Well, of course, India has already discussed how India can help the Afghan government yesterday during the bilateral. And, of course, India is involved in infrastructure projects in terms of capacity building. And, of course, if you look at the readout by the Afghan side, it has noted India's role when it comes to the Afghan peace process, saying that how India is helping in consensus development in the region when it comes to the Afghan peace process. There are, of course, reports of India engaging with Taliban, and the Afghan one was speaking to Vyond said that India can ask Taliban to make sure that it disengages or cuts its ties with regional terror groups.
Right, Sidhan, thank you so much for all your inputs, and thank you for joining us at this hour. Beyond World is One is now available in your country. Download the app now and get all the news updates on the move.